Welcome to Amsterdam, the city of canals, bicycles, and home to one of the most fascinating and flamboyant figures in Dutch history. Today, we're going to take a closer look at the colorful life of Willem Arondeus. Willem Arondeus was a Dutch artist, writer, and gay rights activist. He was born in 1894 and grew up in a conservative family that didn't approve of his artistic aspirations or his sexual orientation. But that didn't stop him from pursuing his dreams and living life to the fullest. Willem was a rebel from a young age. He started painting and drawing when he was just a child, and he never stopped creating. He studied art in Amsterdam and quickly became known for his bold and colorful paintings. But Willem wasn't just an artist. He was also a writer and a poet. He wrote several books, including a biography of the Dutch painter Matthijs Maris. But it was his work as a gay rights activist that really set him apart. Willem was an openly gay man in a time when homosexuality was illegal in the Netherlands. But he refused to hide who he was or apologize for his identity. Willem fought tirelessly for LGBTQ+ rights, organizing protests and demonstrations and using his art and writing to raise awareness of the issues facing the community. Willem's most famous act of resistance came during World War II, when he joined the Dutch resistance and helped to forge and distribute fake identity papers to Jews and others who were being persecuted by the Nazis. This was a dangerous and daring mission, but Willem was willing to risk everything to help those in need. He knew that the Nazis were systematically rounding up and deporting Jews, and he wanted to do something to stop them. He recruited a team of artists and writers to help him create fake identity papers, and they worked in secret, hiding in basements and attics. A major detriment to the success of these forgeries was the Municipal Office for Population Registration, as its existence made the forgeries less useful, since their legitimacy could be checked against the registration lists and determined to be fakes. In 1943, Arondeus and his associates developed a plan to destroy the registration office. Their attack, which took place on March 27, was partially successful and they managed to destroy 800,000 identity cards. The building was blown up and although no one was caught on the night of the attack, due to an unknown betrayer, Arondeus was arrested on April 1. He was interrogated and tortured, but he refused to give up the names of his colleagues or the location of the forged papers. On the 18th of June 1943, Willem was tried and sentenced to death. He pleaded guilty and assumed the full blame, which may be why two young doctors were spared from execution. Before his execution, Arondeus made a point of ensuring the public would be aware that he and two other men in the group, Bakker and Brouwer, were gay, asking either a friend of his lawyer to tell people that homosexuals are not cowards. He was a trailblazer, an artist, a writer, and a hero. He fought for what he believed in, and he never gave up. He was, and still is, an inspiration to us all. He is a different kind of icon.